What's your dream car? Something fast, sleek, fuel efficient? Well, mine is all of those, and it runs on salt water. Hello, gearheads and geeks alike. I'm Julian for DNews, and I have a tasty treat for both of you. The car is unquestionably one of the most important inventions ever. It's made transportation available to the masses and independence available to teenagers. Most of our daily lives aren't possible without one. But the car as we know it has some huge challenges looming over it in the not so distant future. First, there's the problem of what goes into it. Gasoline is an oil product, and oil isn't renewable in any way. It's a resource that will one day be too scarce to meet demands. And while sources disagree on when that's going to happen exactly, it's likely going to be within my lifetime. Now, even if gasoline is replaced with ethanol from renewable sources, there's still the issue of what comes out of the internal combustion engine, carbon dioxide. CO2 is the most common greenhouse gas, and in the US, 32% of that comes from transportation. So our cars, while useful, are not sustainable and are contributing to almost a third of the CO2 that's destabilizing our climate. There has to be a better way. Electric cars look to be that way. They allow us to still be mobile and independent, but battery-powered cars take a long time to charge when they run out of juice. Instead of a 5-minute fill-up, drain batteries of electric cars can take 1 to 8 hours, depending on the kind of car and charging station. Fast charging can cut that time to 30 minutes, but if you do that all the time, the battery could be ruined in 3 years, and replacements will likely cost thousands. And don't forget that that electricity has to come from somewhere, and in the US, that somewhere is likely a coal power plant. Electricity production is the only source of CO2 bigger than transportation. But electric motors can be powered by other means. Liquid hydrogen, when recombined with oxygen, can be used to generate an electric current, and the only waste product is dihydrogen monoxide, more commonly called water. Hydrogen is the most abundant element in the universe, so we probably aren't going to run out. And delivering it in liquid form means that you preserve that splash and dash ability gas cars enjoy. But to keep hydrogen in a liquid state, it has to be stored at high pressure. This raises issues of safety, and we as a species already have to be reminded not to light a cigarette at gas stations. Now, however, there's a third option. German company Nanoflow Cell debuted their Quant e-sportlimousine at the Geneva Motor Show this year, and its goal is to be the first saltwater-powered production car in the world. The Quant e-sportlimousine has 2 tanks of liquid with dissolved metallic salts that give them opposite charges. These are pumped through a membrane, and the process of recombining them generates electricity. Nanoflow Cell claims one fill-up is good for over 300 miles. That's surprisingly car-like, though the combined volume of the tanks is over 3 times that of a large SUV, so fill-ups will take longer, but certainly not hours, and without the hazards of liquid hydrogen or gasoline. More than that, the Quant e-sportlimousine, despite its ridiculous name, is quite a handsome thing. And the company promises performance figures like 0 to 60 in 2.8 seconds and a top speed of over 200 miles per hour. And best of all, it's just been approved for testing on European roads. Now, personally, I couldn't care if it looked like an ugly Christmas sweater and made fun of my ears. If there's a car that can run on salt water with no emissions, I want one yesterday. Cutting-edge electronics are awesome in all forms, and another cool no-tech you'll probably be seeing a lot more of is wireless charging. If you want to learn the science behind it, Trace has you covered with a video right here. Now, what do you think the next big transportation innovation is? Let us know down below. And don't forget to subscribe. I couldn't think of a rhyme for that one. But thanks for watching.